Hello. Okay, so I've done the first two games, Ratchet and Clank 1 and Ratchet and Clank 1 Commando, so I figured, you know what, let's start on up your arsenal, but I apologize ahead of time. I have a rager of a headache, and I'm not in the best of moods right now. So I'm gonna go in this anyways, mostly silent while I try to focus on the game without, you know, splitting in half. But hopefully we all have a good time here, and always feel free, just because I'm in a bad mood doesn't mean I don't want to hear from you guys, so feel free to message or chat or whatever, what have you. So yeah, let's begin.
Snaggle beast devours your mutant swamp fly. Oh yeah, I bet you didn't see that one coming.
Hey, what are you doing?
Check and mate.
What? That's cheating.
On the contrary, the rules clearly state that the Blargian snaggle beast has an allergic reaction to swamp flies that last two turns. Ooh, it is on again.
Your luck is extraordinary, sir. But do you lose as gracefully as you win?
I would not know, Maximilian. I never lose.
There is a first time for everything.
Agent Crank! His secret agent.
Shocking. Bring the car around, Jeeves, and mind the ejector seat this time.
Stay tuned for more Secret Agent Clank.
That was terrific.
Yeah, great. Change the channel.
But the man said to stay tuned.
We continue our live coverage from Velden. Just hours ago, the planet was attacked without warning by a terrifying alien race known as the Tyranoids. Officials believe that an evil robotic supervillain known as Dr. Nefarious is the mastermind behind the Tyranoid attack. As you can see, the Galactic Rangers are putting up a valiant fight. But they are no match for these tentacle-eyed terrors. Indeed, this backwater planet may be completely destroyed in a matter of hours. Darla Gratch, Channel 64 News.
We're going home.
But Velden is in the Solana galaxy. Oh no, not the gravimetric warp drive. The untested gravimetric warp drive. The one you built from Blargian scrap metal?
Coming?
We are doomed.
You were saying?
I stand corrected.
I just hope we're not too late.
Client 91802, and welcome back to the Solana Galaxy.
These must be the Galactic Rangers.
Hey, look! It's a new sergeant!
Huh?
Hey, Sarge, you can have my gun. There's too many of them! We're all gonna die!
I do have an issue. Options, controls.
April to fire your shock blaster.
Oh yeah, no, I don't want that camera inverted.
You, Sarge. We're pinned down by that enemy vehicle. Somebody's gotta take it out.
Let me guess. That somebody is me.
We got a volunteer. Here, Sarge, take this. We'll cover you. From back there!
Try using the... Select weapons, hold triangle, and select an icon with the left analog stick. Hold L1 to precisely target your weapon.
Give me a second. I think I know the issue. Plug in. All right, I applied a dead zone. No.
You can reverse the camera control.
All right, let's try. Plugin settings, let's just remove them.
Controls in the options menu.
There we go.
Nanotech level has increased.
Don't tell me I have to reverse this again. I do want subtitles though. Yeah, I think that's better.
Ooh.
What's the situation?
The Nordics have fallen back to a base in F-Sector. We have orders to go in and take them out. F-Sector? No way. Game over, man. We're all gonna end up as scrap metal.
Get back in there, Trooper. We've got a planet to save.
Sir, yes, sir.
I love how Ratchet just kind of accepted it.
Has upgraded. Weapons upgrade automatically when they're used frequently. Hold circle to charge up the shock blaster for a more powerful attack.
Release those Tyranoids!
Down L2 or R2 while running.
Destroy that vehicle! Sir, we have a transmission from the president!
How are things on the front line, soldier? Is that Secret Agent Clank?
Greetings, sir. We are here to help.
Well, this is an honor, and I see you brought your chauffeur along.
What? No. Hold on a second, sir.
Agent Clank, we must stop Dr. Nefarious. As you may know, only one man has ever faced him and survived. I've just received a top-secret report on that man's whereabouts. Here, take a look.
On tonight's episode of Nature's Mysteries, we examine the Florana tree beast. Deep in the dense growth of Florana's Jambu Forest lives a mysterious creature. Or maybe he doesn't. It's one of nature's mysteries.
I've seen him run right through our camping site. He was buck naked, screaming and holding a banana. Or maybe it weren't a banana. It could be.
One of nature's mysteries. Legend tells that this mysterious creature is actually one of the greatest superheroes who ever lived. Shamed by his recent past, he is now one of nature's mysteries. Tune in and find out the answers.
We need you to find this man. The fate of the galaxy may depend on it.
Are you sure this is the guy you're looking for, Mr. President? Yeah, he seems like kind of a, you know, wacko.
You may be right, but he's the best chance we've got. I know you boys won't let me down.
You can count on us, sir.
Controller can be configured with multiple button maps, including a map that places the fire command on R1. To change to a different button map, press Start, then enter the Options menu and select Controls.
What were you saying?
The jackpot crate multiplies all bolts and experience gained for a limited time. To perform a high jump, hold R1 and press X. To perform a long jump, run, then press R1 and X at the same time.
Climb a ladder by jumping onto it and pressing X until you reach the top.
Oh, that's just maxed ammo. Okay.
Your armor and wrench attack have been greatly increased for a limited time. Between walls, jump, then press X in midair while next to a wall.
Sorry, excuse me.
Ratchet, we have company.
Where?
Behind you.
Where?
Behind you.
Very funny. You having a good time?
You trespass on sacred ground. Now you walk path of death.
But, sir...
Path of death!
I guess it's just that easy to leave, huh?
To enter the camera, tap L1.
Okay, we walked your path of death. Now, tell us what you know about Dr. Nefarious.
Who? Huh?
Dr. Nefarious! They say you're the only man to ever beat him.
Who? Huh?
Jeez, this guy's even dumber than...
Captain Quark?
Yeah, Captain Quark! That's it, Quark. You've had this coming for a long time. Quark has completely lost his mind. Now what?
Just keep the mask on. He thinks you are his new leader.
Great.
Incoming call.
This is Captain Sasha of the Starship Phoenix. The President has asked me to assist you.
Hi.
I see you have located Captain Quark.
Yeah, we got him, but, well, he thinks he's a monkey.
Of course. Bring him to the Phoenix and we'll see what we can do. Sasha out.
Milkshake.
Look at that, Clank. This ship is amazing.
Welcome aboard the Phoenix, gentlemen.
Whoa.
Impressive, isn't she? The Phoenix is the pride of the Galactic Fleet. She's equipped with the latest technology. Holodeck training suite, auto vendors for armor and weapons, virtual firing range, starfighter upgrade system, even a Gadgetron VG-9000 game system.
A VG-9000?
Of course. With a Mavix Fireball Pro controller, VR headset, and a zero-G dance pad attachment.
Will you marry me?
Well, you've obviously had an exhausting trip. Why don't you stop by your quarters? We prepared a custom living area for Quark, so he won't get in your way. Come meet me on the bridge when you're ready.
To view the world map, press Select or R3.
Hmm. That's satisfying. Weapons.
This is our onboard Gadgetron armor vendor. We'll notify you whenever a new suit of armor is available for purchase. Welcome to the Phoenix Trophy Room. Whenever a crew member is awarded a Medal of Honor, it is displayed here. This is the Phoenix VR deck. Here you can train in combat simulations or practice using new gadgets. These are your quarters. I set up the VG9000 to play vid comic discs.
How do you think he got like this?
Well, the life of an intergalactic superhero can be very stressful.
Yeah. Anyway, you're telling me this nutcase is our only hope for stopping Nefarious? We're hosed.
This is the VG9000 game system. If you have a VidCon...
Yeah, we play Ouya. How's it going, SPP? Just tight.
Great. Meet me on the bridge.
I'd be lying if I said decently. It's been a fucked off day plus a massive headache, so just trying to chill. But oh well. It's okay. Shit happens.
You could disable help.
But I appreciate the worry.
We're losing the signal. Try boosting the power.
Isn't that the president?
They came out of nowhere. Tyranoid invasion force. Presidential compound has been breached. Cannot hold out much longer here.
I like that.
Mr. President. Dad, are you there?
Dad?
Robotic citizens of the Solana Galaxy, the hour of your liberation is at hand! Too long have we robots suffered under the bigotry, the stupidity, the squishiness and foul stench of organic life forms. Soon, all robots will bask in the liberty and equality of my benevolent, iron-fisted rule. As for you filthy organic life forms, you can look forward to being disintegrated! That's all for now.
Plot a course from Arcadia. Maximum speed. Prepare the dropship for planetary assault. We're going in.
We'll see you on Arcadia.
Never mind, having a tough time playing small games, bring out some nostalgia. Life makes a bit more... Yeah, I totally feel ya. And I really like that quote. The one that I always follow by is, it's an old proverb, but I can't remember who said it, but it's, heroism is hanging on 1 minute longer. And that just always hit home for me. I mean, I've always wanted to be somebody's hero, so why not hold out? I think, like, good, like, sayings are good to live by, you know?
Yeah.
My other favorite saying is, oh, fuck off. Sorry, that's not what the saying is, but it's the one I always laugh at is, life sucks and then you die. Well, my thing blacked out, so. Especially in South Africa. Is that where you are now? That's interesting. Yeah, I've heard. Is Myanmar there? I've heard things in Myanmar, South Africa. Just the whole world's gone to shit, basically. Namely those, the, I would say third world, but I don't want to be like offensive. You know what I mean? So where are you now, if I may ask? Ireland. That's a bit of a distance. What brings you up there? Keep your head down. The Terranoids are crawling all over the place. That's more than reasonable, and I'm glad you're safe. Hopefully, there becomes a good resolution for what's happening down in there. No worries, man. You come to the final stream, you get cared for. From a distance, of course. I'm not sure what much I can do. You know what I mean? I like to be supportive where I can. And compassionate where I can't.
Tap triangle to cycle through the last three weapons you have equipped.
You got Ratchet and Clank, hell yeah. So what are you up to today, man? Apologies, I say man, but I mean that like in a general gender like neutral kind of greeting. L2 and R2. Modding a PS2 fat hoverboard. What's the difference between that and a thin motherboard? Okay, well, I'd just rather be safe, you know? Make sure people know that I'm, don't mean like anything behind it. The motherboard is half the size of fat. Nice. Requires, who is that? Kohler's 59, thanks for the follow. How's it going? Requires less voltage. Always. Sorry. How the hell do I get the platinum bolt? I have a fat motherboard on hand right now, so I'm modding that. Okay. There we are. Oh, it's titanium this time. Alright. How can I remember? So what are you modding it to do? Just like, be more powerful, or?
Nice shooting, sir. A second wave of pteranoids just landed. They're attacking the compound from the other side. We could sure use your help.
You got it.
Follow me to the dropship.
Give it like a comet-like processing power. Just make it run stupidly fast. NVIDIA graphics card. The whole nine yards. HDMI port, maybe a line upscaler to play PS1. Nice.
Use the strafe feature to reach your full combat potential. To strafe, hold down L2.
Sarge, you're just in time. We must defend the presidential palace.
PSU from the bulky switch mode, PSU to slimming mode. Nice. PS2's hardware is really exotic compared to the last two PlayStation models. What do you mean the last two? Wasn't there only the PS1? Oh, okay.
Sarge, cover those Rangers. If we lose the whole squad, it's all over. Incoming!
What's exotic about it, out of curiosity? I might not understand, I just like to make conversation, you know? PS2's instruction set was custom made by Sony. So I was 1 enemy away from winning that. God fucking damn it.
We need to take out those enemy dropships. The sauces are just icing on the cake.
Also, I mean, the PS2 the ability much more math than the PS1. Skilled developers can do some cool stuff. Yeah. Second, I just realized it's really loud. Like Jack 1 and Ratchet and Clank. Yeah. Actually, you want to know something interesting? When I was in college, and I went to college for video game development, two of my teachers actually assisted on developing the lighting engine for the Dolphin project, which is now known as the GameCube. Yeah, it's nutty, and I think it's just like a good teaching moment. It is a small world. The rest were, or most of them came from Silicon Knights, which developed Too Human, which I know is not like the greatest game, but it's interesting to hear what they did. Oh, Shiro, thanks for the lurk. Really appreciate it, man. Under the gun. Provide covering fire to the repair crew. Really good.
Protect the repair crew. We need that turret back online.
Ooh, it has shock powers now. Another cool fact: the renderware for Ratchet and Clank was actually provided to Insomniac from Naughty Dog. I believe that's why Naughty Dog and Insomniac have such a sisterhood to their game companies. Like, I know Jack and Daxter and Ratchet and Clank rip on each other a lot, but... Actually, interesting fact, I've never played Jack and Daxter. I used to have a PS2, but never played it. Insomniac rewrote the code and handed back to them. Yeah. I can see it happening. As much as people think that, like, game companies have, like, this, mutual hatred for each other, it's actually... It depends on the company. Like, you don't see, like, EA or Blizzard doing that kind of thing, but often video game companies will help each other out in that kind of aspect. I'm hoping to one day, like, start my own game company and help other smaller game companies with that kind of thing. Their offices were back to backs. I could see that. Sorry, excuse me. Where on earth am I aiming?
The repairs are finished. Now we'll give those noids a taste of their own medicine.
Use the ball cranks to activate the automated turns in sequence.
The noids have launched an all-out assault. We need those air defenses online yesterday.
Enemies appear red on the radar. Allies appear blue. Mission objectives appear green.
See, I make all this big talk about starting my own game company, but my plan is to make a game company after I release my first game. But that means I'm gonna have to put in effort into my first game. Hopefully, Skybreakers is a decent hit.
Agent Clank.
Oh boy.
You're even more impressive in person than you are on the holovid. And I must say, I've never seen a chauffeur fight like you do, son. Who says you can't find good help these days, right, Clank? Sasha's told me a lot about you. Don't get any ideas, kid. She is way out of your league. Sasha filled me in on the Quark situation. I'm told the man thinks he's a monkey?
He has lost his memory, sir.
Well, then you'll simply have to find it for him. We need our star player back in the game ASAP. Is that understood?
Yes, sir.
My daughter tells me you're a man who's good with his hands, Ratchet.
Ooh. Sir, I swear I am.
The city's laser shield went down during the attack. Now, we are defenseless without it. I sent out a repairman to fix it, but he disappeared. I need you to get that shield system back online.
Yes, sir. We're on it.
Have you played the new Rifts Apart? I forget if you said or not.
You'll need this refractor gadget to restore
power. Have they kept up with the, like, the jokes?
Those laser beams are red hot, so make sure you turn the refractor field on before you touch them. Good luck.
Refractor will let you redirect laser beams.
Also, I was told that there's no plumber in Rifts Apart, and that kind of made me a bit sad. Oh, fuck. Most parts, slightly, there are around 15 inches where I feel the humor from the OG. Well, at least it's not, like, barren, you know?
Just hold L1 to aim the reflected beams.
Aw, damn. He was a good character from the, like, the OG game. I'm glad they kind of kept up with this joke that he's like this omnipresent being. And all he wants to do is plumb. Probably as close as we will get to the PS2 games in the modern day. Yeah, I think the most recent Ratchet & Clank game that I've ever played, I think is probably Tools of Destruction. I think. I did play a little bit of All for One, but it was like a demo, so I don't know if exactly. Oops. I don't know if that accounts.
There should be a spider symbol somewhere in that room. Use the beam to lead the spider drone over the symbol.
And you know what? Those were good times. I always think, like, the as much as people rag on it, the GameCube and PS2 era was probably the most, I guess, ingenious for developers, because, like, I think game development really was, like, taken off, and, like, people wanted to try out some new stuff. And, like, if people had the guts today that, like, like PS2 and GameCube developers have had, then I think people would kind of not be as toasty as they are about games like Call of Duty and whatnot. Like, don't get me wrong, I still think there's some, like, ingenious things out there, but, you know. I do wish Sony didn't kind of have, like, the stranglehold on certain developers, because I think, like, what was it, like, I think it was Insomniac said they would like to develop for PC one day, but I guess, like, their contract with PlayStation. Clever workarounds that used to get the most performance in the hardware is something we'll never likely really see again, as most games aren't made with so many proprietary custom tools. That and the limits, like, if, like, some of Crash Bandicoot's, like, the first one, like, some of the things, like, about that about Crash 1 that they had to fit in into the hardware, it's actually really cool to watch.
Hey, look, it's Al. Got the shields up yet?
Silence! I am concentrating.
What the? That's a Quark Vid comic.
Excuse me. It is a historically accurate interactive graphic novel.
How can you use the city's defense network to play a video game?
Simple. I bypassed the security server with a 626 hex matrix adapter and reprogrammed the graphic subprocessor.
No, I mean, Clank, you speak, nerd.
It appears you have a feedback loop in the induction coils of your DB3 signal processor.
Impossible! I ran a recursive check thumb on the signal matrix. Hey, there is a feedback loop. I don't know where that could be with a different loop.
May we borrow this vid comic?
Treat it gently.
Yeah.
The first edition.
Perhaps this will help restore Quark's memory.
Shield power restored.
Yeah. That, and I believe I don't remember who it was, but someone on Naughty Dog basically invented, like, a more streamlined and less resource intensive way of doing per vertex animation, which is why you get some really cool animations from Crash. I like talking game dev. It actually makes me feel smart for once. Yeah, basically, in order to make the 3D animations to actually look half decently, they had to do something like each vertex was on only like 3 bits, and like it was set local to the position to get kind of thing.
Meticulously reconstructed by our crack research team with the aid of eyewitness accounts, bathroom gossip, wild speculation. And a magic eight ball. In the
Sorry,
early days
drinking.
Of the fifth Solarian equinox, the Solana galaxy was terrorized by a notorious pirate known as Captain Blackstar.
Ahoy! Anybody else got a craving for fish and chips?
Though still in the prime of his youth, Captain Quark was already a living legend.
I was beating him up with a stick.
However, no previous adventure could have prepared Quark for his encounter with the dread pirate Blackstar and his crew of... Please tell me this is a typo.
That's robotic pirate ghosts. Guess reading wasn't your subject, eh, Professor?
Right. Now we begin the interactive portion of Episode 1. Booty is in the eye of the beholder.
Yeah.
You just picked up an officially licensed Quark token. Collect all the tokens in the level to earn a secret prize. Bling, bling, baby. The red ones are worth 10 Quark tokens.
Didn't someone code the people to be able to play, like Twitch chat does, Quark VidComic? See, I've always wanted to do like Twitch chat develops a video game, in which case like Twitch chat basically just tells me every aspect of the game they want, story, animations, etc., gameplay.
Precision aiming.
I think it'd be difficult, though. Would you make a custom engine? I have no experience making custom engines, unfortunately. It would have to be something based off Unity. Oh, I didn't realize how low I was. Otherwise, I would like to. If I had the chance to make my own engine, with the knowledge that I have, possibly. I think it'd be cool.
Thank you.
Yeah. I mean, I'd accept help from, like, known developers. Like, maybe, I don't know, what was it, Tiny Build? Tiny Build is good for that. For wanting to help others. They tried helping out with Yandere Dev, but we all know their shit show that is Yandere Dev. Honestly, I don't know how people can be so rude. Come on. Get up.
Juicy health upgrade. Remember, cadets, there's one in every level.
Also, apologies. I do have a thing against rude devs. Gotta love iframes and punching. Hell yeah.
I mean, I've worked on some real junk, but this one takes the cake. Pirate, ghost, robots. What do they think? We're idiots?
Hey, Professor, snap to it.
Once again, the citizens of the Solana Galaxy owed their lives to the dauntless courage of the remarkable man behind the cube. With great reluctance, Quark accepted a meager fee for his services and promptly donated the entire sum to the Quark for Tots Scholarship Fund, a charity providing makeovers and buxom bimbos for needy people named Quark.
I've got a big heart. Mr. President? Yes, I got the fruit basket, thanks. It turns out I'm allergic to prunes. Yeah, who knew? What? Blackwater City's under attack. Yes, sir, I'm on my way.
The exciting, all true, right, adventures of Captain Quark continue in episode 2.
Of devil.
It appears Quark has regained his memory.
Hey, this dressing room isn't fit for a pig. What kind of shoddy production are you people running?
That's him, all right.
He may need a while to adjust. In the meantime, I've got a mission that's perfect for you too. We've just learned of a prototype holographic device that can disguise the user as a Tyranoid, even allowing him to speak Tyranese.
Is it just me, or do you smell bananas?
Anyway... The device happens to be the grand prize on this week's Annihilation Nation. Check it out.
Tonight on Annihilation Nation, we feature an all-new Death Course. Let's meet tonight's victim. Oops, I mean contestant, Fred.
Isn't that guy from the first game?
An accountant who claims he once had a morpho ray go off in his pants. What a chance. Let's take a look at what he's up against. Doesn't look too bad now, does it? Good luck, Fred! Next!
Another day, another death course.
Let's meet our first contestant. He's an unemployed rocket mechanic who claims to have saved two galaxies, but most people know him as Secret Agent Clang's bumbling chauffeur. He hopes that disguising himself as a Tyranoid will make him more attractive to the ladies.
Hey.
Give a warm welcome to Ratchet. Ratchet will attempt to be the first contestant ever to survive the Death Course. Contestant number one, are you ready?
Bring it on.
You know, I know something is going to do this. What's the look sensitivity? Holy crap.
L2 or R2 while running.
Yeah, this game is much harder, or these... The trilogy's been much harder with just a GameCube controller. Can I blow that up? Oh.
Close.
Knew there was a skill point there.
Ouch! He's gonna feel that tomorrow. This little guy can really move.
Hmm. base. Thank you, Schematics. What's the progress on that so far, by the way? Also, hey, Schematics, how's it going?
Do not be alarmed, Sasha. That is Ratchet.
Oh, I see you won the Terror Guys. It's very convincing. Anyway, there's something I think the two of you need to see.
Quirk personal log entry 101301. After I personally vanquished the Protopet Menace and revamped the Megacorp testing facility, I decided to focus my efforts on protecting the endangered creatures of the Florana jungle. But when news arrived that Dr. Nefarious had again risen to power, I knew where my true destiny lay. The training necessary to get back into tip-top shape has been exhausting, and my mind overflows with brilliant concepts. Though I still yearn for the bittersweet stench of my simian companions. Time has come to resume my duties as the greatest hero the galaxy has ever known, Captain Quark!
I will say, in the newer games, I miss his butt chin.
You're not gonna believe this, but the President put Quark in charge of the fight against Nefarious. Our new commander just called his first team meeting. You better get back to the Phoenix right away.
I agree. This does not sound good.
Games need more butt chin.
Now it's time to get down and dirty for a lowdown. Go down.
Thank you,
Oh boy.
Charged up to release a spectacular beam of death.
Floor traps. Okay.
Hold the fire button to charge up the beam.
I have no ammo. I do gotta say, I like how much faster things level up in this game. Oh boy.
This event is a time limit challenge.
Crap, I'm out of ammo already. Nice. That was way too easy with that shock cannon.
Wonder what it-
Did you see that? This event is a time limit challenge.
Gonna have to do this with one weapon, folks.
To throw your whip, hold R1 and press circle.
All right.
Can the challenge be won with one weapon?
Ouch!
He's gonna feel that tomorrow.
Ooh, he's got sharp teeth too. I wonder if he bites.
Okay, folks, time to play Luck of the Draw! I'm now pulling a ticket stub out of my hat.
Ouch!
He's gonna feel that tomorrow.
Oh, hey, you guys. It's been a while. How's it going? Unfortunately, I don't have that. Sorry.
Audience member in seat number 326, get ready to try your luck.
Come on.
In the robot rampage.
Oh no, God, please not me.
Anyways, how's it going, man? Been a while.
How about that, folks?
Oh boy. Yeah, I'm not doing that.
Pay attention, folks. This time we're gonna switch the challenge mode in mid-round.
Of course, take your time, man. Sure. How would you go about doing that? Yes.
Did somebody say it?
This weapon upgrade features a lock-on mod. To lock on to enemies, press and hold L2 and R2.
Yeah, no worries, no worries. Yes. Sure, but are you okay with just, actually give me a second. Estas bien si es solo temporal? Okay. Uh, Give me a second here. I gotta figure out how to do this. I think I did that right. Let me try again. Okay, yeah, you should have your mod now. It's Moobot, not Nightbot. Let me check. Where is Moobot? Apparently there's a Russian roulette in here. Oh, wait, no, never. Oh, that's watching. Oops, sorry. Sorry about that. I'm just trying to figure out things here. Let me try. All right, now let me. Custom commands. Oh, it's apparently already a thing. All right, it should be enabled. Try it. Try follow age. Okay, try someone else try that. It's probably just because it was me. No, just try follow age. I think I already fixed it. I think I got it working. Creo que lo tengo funcionando. Creo que lo. Uh, Pareva L. Commando. Hey, awesome. I'm glad it works. I will have to unmod you now, though. I appreciate your help, though. There you go. You should still be, like, an active viewer, but not a mod. I greatly appreciate your help, though. Awesome. Oh, fuck. Fuck. No! Oh. Oh. That definitely helped, thank you. Oh, fuck. Well, I'm glad you've stuck around for the 3 months. Greatly appreciate it. Oh, boy. Oh boy. Get rid of. Oh, fuck. Oh, I'm so thankful for that. Oh. Well, at least you're learning. Oh fuck. Oh boy. Okay, I'm retiring. If you need any command, let me know. Thank you. Thanks for stopping by. Hope you have a good rest.
See ya.
Why am I allowed up here? This is a really easy course. Man, these courses are too easy. I gotta get the Hydra for this one.
circle to target multiple enemies with the spitting hydra. Release circle to fire.
That was easy. I thought this was supposed to be hard. I'm glad that I was able to make my weapons much stronger. I think my headache is mostly subsided, but I still have a little bit of a frontal pain.
Ladies and gentlemen, oh, and Helga, welcome to the Q-Force. You have been assembled here because each of you is an expert in your particular field. From Al's mastery of electronics to Skid's nerves of steel, hey! To Helga's sensual powers of seduction. Each of you has shown that you are worthy to wear the Q. Years ago, I single-handedly defeated Dr. Nefarious, but like a rash on the galaxy's backside, he has flared up again. Our first mission will be to infiltrate the Doctor's top secret base on planet Aquatos. Impossible, you say? Perhaps for a lesser strategist. Behold, my brilliant plan!
First, Ratchet and Clank will descend to the sea floor and wade through a series of tunnels flooded with waist-high raw sewage.
What?
Please hold your questions until the end of the presentation. After infiltrating the base, our agents will split up. Clank will enter the base's ventilation system, where he will locate and deploy this banana-guided autonomous monkey device, or the GAMD. Meanwhile, Ratchet will use his extensive knowledge of the Tyrannoid language and customs to win the trust of the bloodthirsty alien guards. Finally, our agents will make their way to Nefarious's personal office, steal everything that isn't nailed down, and exfiltrate the base completely undetected.
That's crazy!
But it just might work.
Alrighty.
Captain Thatcher!
Speak freely.
Are we there yet?
Negative.
I
urgently need to know how the Quark versus Nefarious VidComic series ends. When are you going to play your new comic?
If anybody finds a Starmaster scientific calculator, please contact Lost and Found.
Quark, Comic Episode 2, Ariba Amoeba. A new evil was gathering in the shadowy swamps of Blackwater City. A horrific breed of monsters known as Amoeboids, born in the laboratories of a twisted scientist named Dr. Nefarious.
To think, they called me insane, Lawrence. We'll see who's insane when my pets have exterminated all life on this miserable planet!
That should clear things right up, sir. When Captain Quark encountered the Amoeboids for the first time, he immediately executed Emergency Response Plan number 2.
Hey, wait just a minute!
Quark then proceeded to stall for time while he coordinated the city's defenses from the women's restroom at Galaxy Burger.
Give me that thing, you lying no good. Right. Now, where were we? From the moment I touched down, I knew the situation called for a head-on assault. Without hesitation, I rushed to do heroic battle with the monstrous Amoeboid horde. Stuff. Press X while I'm in the air near a wall to see my awesome wall kick move.
Got a wave dash on some.
Thank you.
Oh.
Is there something down here? Nope. Guess not. Wave dance on him. What is that? Splits? Oh. Man, imagine if Ratchet or the, sorry, Insomniac just made like a game all about Captain Quark like this. Oh, awesome.
Nefarious was right about one thing. He and Quark would meet again, and sooner than he realized. For a true hero like Captain Quark will stop at nothing in the name of justice.
What? I held my breath.
All right.
Incoming call. Oh, no.
Clank, Bubby, you're killing me!
Excuse me?
I'm trying to make a picture here, and Mr. Big Shot Star is nowhere to be found.
I am currently occupied with a mission of galactic security.
Right, right. I get it. You want a bigger trailer? Done. You want a daily oil massage? Done. I need my star on the set pronto, capiche?
You're breaking up.
You know, I can see you, weasel boy.
Oh, yeah? How about now? He'll figure something out. We've got work to do.
If I ever get famous and upstarty, I want someone to punch me square in the side of the head.
Skid, what are you doing here?
My code name is Shadow Dude, bro. Black Ops are my especiality. I figured you guys could use my help.
Thanks, Shadow Dude, but I think we've got this one covered.
All right, I'll just take my hacker and go back to the ship.
Hacker? Oh, well, you know, on second thought, I think we'd like you to join the mission, Shadow Dude.
Awesome! This is gonna be sick!
What did I just buy?
The infector fires nanovirus globules that infect enemies on contact. Infected enemies will attack and infect other enemies until the infection wears off.
What on earth have I done? Oh no. I wonder if it'd be different if I leave and come back. Oh no, don't tell me I've well and truly fucked this game up. How on earth did I manage that? Well, I've well and truly fucked up. Like, give me a second here. Alright. Alright, let's hope I fix that. Okay, so the ship is fine. Let's just see if Ratchet and Clank still exists. Okay, good. What the fuck? Okay, well, it seems the emulator does not like Aquatos. I guess it's gonna call it quits. Hopefully I can get that resolved by next time. If not, then we're gonna have to do a shadow playthrough of this. My headache is coming back slightly, so best to do it before I lose my frickin' mind. Give me a second here. Let us find somebody to raid. Oh, and Captain Halloween says hello to everybody. Hello, Elohim. Excuse me. Moist Noggin is streaming. And it looks like he's currently thick into the game, so hopefully it's all good. Raid Moist Noggin. He's my brother. Good streamer. Everybody seems to love him. So if you enjoyed my content, feel free to give me a, sauce me a follow. If you want to help me get closer to emotes, that's the only, like I said last stream, that's the only reason I want, subs at this point is for, like, the third emote slot. Consider subscribing. It definitely helps me, it definitely helps me develop the stream further, get some new stuff. Hopefully eventually I can afford a lamp, put a lamp on the TV and be able to actually track myself instead of, you know, just a static talking avatar. Consider joining the Discord right there. Am I missing anything? Oh yeah, join the community. I greatly appreciate everybody. Everybody's free to talk about whatever they want, as long as it's not bigoted, of course. I hope everybody has a good rest of their day. Take care.